guys, with the crazy world we're living in right now, I'm doing my job to self-isolate myself. I'm coming to you from the Norfolk Southern Train Yard. I'm here alone. There's no other people here except for the people working here. And we're here to check out something rather unique that we don't see every day. Typically when I come here or when people come to rail yards or sections like this, you come to watch train action. Well, today we're going to watch the behind the scenes to see how they maintain the rail yard. We're going to watch what is called maintenance away, MOW, where they are replacing tracks and railroad ties to ensure longevity of the tracks and service here in the rail yard. You're going to see different portions where they're working in different sections, replacing ties, rails, spikes, and all their kind of plates and everything else. And it's kind of crazy to watch, but very exciting and interesting because that's something the general public gets to see. And they even have this really cool, crazy machine dragging long sections of railroad track around. So if you'd like to check it out with me, all you gotta do is hang out here and come along with me.
Thank you.
So we're zooming pretty far in towards the rear portion of the yard. You can see there's a high railer back there, moving some ties around. There's equipment removing ties. It's a whole chain of events that take place within a small section of equipment there. And they work like clockwork. They know what they're doing back there. And they do it quickly as efficiently as possible to get the rails back open for service. And all those arms that you see moving are all being controlled by operators. Those are not automatic machines. Those are operator equipped machines where someone isn't sitting inside there controlling all those movements. And you can see the precise work that they're able to do. It's quite impressive to watch. Machine's like a tank. It goes over rails, goes over ties, it rolls over everything, and it's four-wheel steering. Both front and rear wheels or axles do turn. It makes some pretty tight maneuvering. The other unique thing is that piece of equipment there is CP, Canadian Pacific, and it's being used here at Norfolk Southern. Most likely they purchased it for their own use, but that is a former CP maintenance away vehicle. Later we pick up another section of rail to drag, so we'll be able to get some action of that. Mistaken, that claw he's using has a magnetic plate. And he's able to pick up the metal items and drop them on the cart, all by magnet power. Now, the one thing I want you to focus on is the rail. You guys know how tough rails are to hold the trains and the weight. Just watch how it flexes and bends as they maneuver it around. It's kind of bizarre to watch. Spy something. I'm gonna zoom in and show you. We have an inbound train. I'm not 100% positive. I think that is Reading and Northern. And we have the conductor here controlling the switch. So, as some bonus footage, we're going to get some train action here. They're going through removing the derailers. There's about three or four of them. And once they clear this one, they should be able to come through. Not every day you see a caboose on a freight train. So, pretty special moment here. So it came to a little bit of a standstill. The two locomotives that brought this train here detached from the cars, went on a different track, and picked up about a dozen more cars to connect to this one. So once they meet up and connect them with this line, they're going to continue past me and we'll be able to see the locomotive power. So they went past the switch to switch to this line, and now they're going to bring them and meet up here, freight car to freight car. So they basically just build the train with cars that are already here in the yard. Then they'll continue down to their stops further down the line. So it looks like they're going to pull back on the line they came on and switch to the other line, I believe. Or they could be heading back in the other direction. We'll find out one way or another. Stop with a vengeance there. So it looks like they're still making some maneuvers here. I thought they were finished, but they are thinking they're gonna head onto the train still. And hopefully we'll see them pass by so you can see the locomotive power. Northern SW8, 801, 803. It's always cool seeing these in operation.
If not mistaken, they should be done building the train. It should meet up here and connect to the caboose. So we'll get a nice shot of that connecting, and it should then continue on down the line. So thankfully the rain stopped. I'm gonna stick around, make sure I capture all of it for just for you. Alright, so I definitely learned my lesson. Don't try to predict what trains are going to do because they're very unpredictable. Pretty much everything I said that was going to happen to that train didn't happen. It did the opposite. What ended up happening is the train came here to drop off a load of cars, pick up another load, and go back south towards their main yard in Pittston or further down in Port Clinton. But at least we got to see some train action. I wish the locomotives were able to pass by the crossing here and to see them up close and get the horn action, but I didn't anticipate finding trains here at all, because every time I come here it's always hit and miss. So here's just a nice little extra bonus footage I was able to share with you guys. But let me know what you guys thought of this video, though. Not something I typically film, although I do love everything related to railroading. I never really filmed maintenance away or repairs or track work before, but for me it was interesting to see because it's something that's typically done, you know, on private property behind closed doors. But where I come here, they're very welcoming. You know, the guys always wave to you, they're friendly, they say hey, how you doing? And we got to see, you know, the track being dragged across the road, and the other rails here is bending and flexing like crazy. I didn't know rail could do that, honestly. We got to see the maintenance ways ripping away the ties, stacking them, and then the ones behind me here were picking up the metal plates with the magnet. Overall, it's a pretty cool experience. I spent about an hour here, got some pretty cool footage. And hopefully you guys appreciated what I was able to share with you guys. You know, like I said, I'm doing my self-isolation thing here. You know, I'm here by myself. I do want to get out of the house, stuff like this is allowed to be filmed, you know. So if you guys want to see more videos like this in the future, comment down below, let me know. If you have any information that you want to share and what you've seen today, feel free to share your thoughts. And if you're new to this channel and like this type of content, I encourage you to check out my railroading playlist. And if you want to see more videos, just subscribe and ring that notification bell. If you do, select all. That way you'll get alerted each time I upload a new video. Don't forget you can also follow me on Facebook and you can help support me on Patreon, which does give you exclusive access to upcoming projects. With that said, thank you so much for watching today. Stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.